So pumped! So today is filled with all the Christmas festivities, hoping that the rain holds off because today is not a very beautiful day, as you can see. But
we're gonna start with some coffee.
We're gonna start with some coffee and we're gonna go make it to the parade. The parade's just like down in like downtown, which is where we live. We're gonna take patchouli and see the Christmas parade. It's the 65th Nashville Christmas Parade, so it's pretty iconic. Let's go.
Dumpty has an easy float and not a great fall. 2,500 cubic feet of helium was fed to him, and he has 18 of the king's men and women to make sure that Humpty stays together for the length of the parade.
Do you know what movie we're gonna watch?
We could watch Home Alone.
Home Alone, yeah, it's a good one. That one. I like that one. So yeah, we're just gonna just rest. It's only, what time is it? 10:30. 10:30, so still the rest of the day. Julie, what did you think of Home Alone?
It was great.
She was asleep the whole time. That was actually my first time ever seeing the full thing.
That's so fun.
I know.
It was great, right?
First time ever. And now it's 12:30, so it's time to give Lil Pachu some lunch and then make us something too, probably.
True.
Yeah? Let's get to it. Starving by the time we come back, and we're just so excited to eat the chili. And now that I'm vegan, she makes the vegan version, and it's so good. And you know, I think this just always what comes to my head first.
Yeah,
everything's all about food for me. Yeah, that's definitely something I would carry on.
Okay, so my favorite Christmas tradition. Well, I guess I technically have a little. It's like a little cloth
book.
Yeah, of the night before Christmas. And it's like cute, got all the animation, like the little drawings in it, and it's It's got my name scrawled on the back with like a little green permanent marker.
That is so cute.
Yeah, I got it when I was, man, it must have been like...
Seven?
No, it must have been like two or three when I got it.
Oh, wow.
And we still have it. It's still like around the house. Dan got one too, but I don't know where his is.
That's so cute.
Yeah, so we'll all like sit around the fire. We'll start a little fire. On Christmas Eve, we all sit down and my dad reads it to us.
That's so cute.
Even to this day, like, I still FaceTimed in every Christmas Eve to listen to the story. And...
Okay, so something that I'm definitely looking forward to starting our lives together.
Yeah.
This being our first married Christmas. His family lives in Minnesota, so that's really far away. But we had, so we're going to drive to North Carolina, spend the first half with them, with my family, from the 21st to the 25th. And then the morning after, like, so the 25th we'll open presents and hang out with my family. And then like that at 1 p.m. or something, we are taking a flight to Minnesota, so we will arrive in Minnesota still on Christmas Day so that we can have Christmas dinner with his grandparents and all of his family. And I'm excited for creating new traditions kind of with them in that, like making it like a nighttime thing, maybe going to the ice skating rink.
I'm excited for our little like airport traditions that we're gonna start, like, because so we've talked about how we want to, while we're in the airport, like have little things that we do, like we want to write each other a love letter
every year
and exchange it at the airport
when we're having our like our only alone time. The airport will be our, like, we love our families, but our solitude.
Yeah. Well, and we love traveling.
Our airport is definitely, that time will be very special, I think. And I don't think we'll be very stressed. I feel like a lot of other people will be stressed on that day. Be like, we're just gonna get spiked hot chocolate, exchange love letters, just take it easy. And yeah, I'm just excited for that new tradition. Being able to be with both of our families. It's gonna be a very long Christmas day. It's gonna be so, so good. Like, I'm really excited about it.
What about a favorite Christmas memory?
Two that literally immediately popped to my head. One, I could just say that I really wanted a bass and I got it. And that was it, the end. So that was pretty cool. I just started doing music with my sister. Before that, I played keys a little bit, but that was pretty much, I wasn't really wanting to play keys. I really loved bass, and my parents recognized that, and I loved it. I love playing bass. But then the other one that comes to my head straight away was for years, and I mean for years, I asked for a life-size doll, and
I don't think I even know this one.
Yeah, so I was a kid, so it could have been 2 years, and that's it. But I genuinely felt like it was 4 years in a row that I was asking for a life-size doll, because by the time I received this life-size doll, it was not the size of me. It was the size of my little brother, who was... Chill. Anyway, it was the size of my little brother, who is like 5 years younger than me, but... it was really fun when I finally got her. She was a beautiful life-size doll. She was, I guess Matthew was like 4 or something, so it was his size, maybe 3. She had like beautiful dark hair. She was a black doll. They were like boyfriend and girlfriend. Like, I made Matthew and my doll be dating.
Cute.
And so that was really fun for me, but I loved like finally getting that. Now, it could have been 2 years I asked for it, but it felt like it was several years.
It felt like forever.
Yeah, but I was really excited when I finally got that, and then it was fun that Matthew and the doll were dating in my mind.
Matthew was kind of your little doll anyway.
Oh, he was, for sure.
There's one year that, like, always sticks in my head. I must have been, like, 6 or so. And at the time, I was, like, super into action figures. Never was, like, allowed to watch G.I. Joe or anything like that. There's this one action figure called the Max Steel. And then one Christmas, there was a new one that came out. It was the Max Steel Panther Combat. He had a little, like, metal claw in one hand. And then he had a sword in the other one. And he had, like, these little cuts on him from being in the jungle and fighting panthers and stuff. My parents told me that it was too violent for me to have at that age. So they were like, nope, can't do that. Sorry, I know you really want it, but we can't get you that. It's just too violent and it's got a sword and all this other stuff.
Threw away the idea.
Few months roll around, I threw away the idea. I was like, okay, well, maybe I want a skateboard. Maybe I want, you know, something like that, whatever. Christmas morning rolls around and I'm the one in my family that always gets up early. And I go at like, I don't know, 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning and just go sleep by the tree. I don't know when it started, I don't know why it started, but I went down and fell asleep by the tree, and then everybody came out to open presents around 7 o'clock. And the first present I picked to like open was from Santa. I went to open it, and it was the Max Steel action figure, the Panther Combat action figure.
The one.
That my parents told me that I couldn't get, but Santa got it for me anyway.
Oh, that Santa. That bad, bad Santa.
I know.
Given five gifts.
But it was the most magical Christmas I've ever had, I think.
Aww. So Santa's presents to us were always family presents. Like
what?
Santa would always give us a game for the family, or movie for the family. Santa never really brought individual gifts as much.
Gotcha.
It was more like always for the family.
That's cute.
Which I thought was...
Santa always got us a big popcorn tin every year.
That was cute. Family gift. That's cute.
Yeah.
We used to feed the reindeer as well.
Cute.
We would mix in oats and sparkles in this bag and stuff, and then we'd throw it out and for the reindeer. Well, I think we did that one year, but it stuck with me. Yeah, I loved it.
Yeah.
I loved it.
Did you guys put out cookies for Santa? Did you guys do the whole thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We would always put out cookies and milk and a letter saying thank you to Santa for the year before. And
I'm freaking excited for our future family.
Yeah. It's going to be
vegan.
So fun.
Christmas vegan. Cookies and almond milk.
Yeah, exactly.
Santa.
Almond milk, drinking it by itself, not always the best.
Santa, there's no way you're going to get through all those chimneys. Like that. Anyway.
Maybe if you cut the dairy and eggs.
Yeah. So.
We'd always get a letter from Santa to our family the next morning.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
I don't remember that. I remember we would write a letter to Jesus every year. Thanking Jesus.
Yeah.
Aw. Right. And it's not Frosty the Snowman. What made Frosty come to life?
The hat.
The old silk hat. What Christmas decoration was originally made from strands of silver?
Is it just the tinsel?
Yep. Who played George Bailey in the Christmas classic It's a Wonderful Life?
Oh, I don't know what his name is.
Jimmy Stewart. Per a recent holiday fad, what spy hides around the house reporting back to Santa on who has been naughty and nice?
Elf on the Shelf.
Yes.
Nice.
What Christmas beverage is also known as milk punch?
Eggnog.
One of Santa's reindeer shares a name with a famous symbol of Valentine's Day. Which reindeer is that?
Vixen?
Cupid.
Oh, dear God.
Duh.
I mean, but if you have a good Valentine's, you get yourself a little vixen.
Oh my gosh. What Christmas-themed ballet premiered in St. Petersburg, Russia in 1892?
The Nutcracker.
All right, we're done with those.
Done.
What are you expecting I'm going to get you?
Big hug.
I just told you I have to purchase it. Where do you think I'm going to purchase a big hug?
Maybe Santa. You're just buying out Santa for the night.
Dirty.
Get yourself a vixen.
Oh, my word. Oh, okay.
Okay, what do I actually think that you're getting me?
Yeah, I think you're getting me something, for the house.
I am not that rude.
I feel like you are.
I'm not going to get you a broom for Christmas.
I mean, I wouldn't be mad about it.
I mean, you are the type that likes gifts you can use. Miss, I asked for bed sheets for how many years?
There's a couple. All right, everybody, so we're just going to enjoy our night tonight. Probably watch some Friends. Maybe some more Christmas movies, but I'm more into the episode mood.
Yeah.
Always, actually.
Always.
Episodes. Always. I always get bored of movies. Always within an episode amount of time. Do you know what I mean?
Yep.
It's 25 minutes, and I'm So, anyway, we're probably going to watch Friends, enjoy our tea, enjoy each other's company. Yeah, this is episode 1 of Vlogmas. This is it, man. It only gets more exciting from here. So, stay tuned. Here we go.